Hey everyone, this is Anthony with MightyCall. Welcome to our detailed guide on how to set up the MightyCall Progressive Dialer. With the Progressive Dialing mode, the system automatically dials the next number from a contact list as soon as there's at least one agent available to take the call. This helps to ensure a steady flow of calls and keeps agents constantly engaged. In this video, you'll see how to start your outbound campaign using the Progressive Dialer mode, and we'll go through every setting you need to know to master this process. To start a new campaign, head over to the Auto Dialer tab and choose Campaigns. Then click the Create Campaign button, where you'll see the four steps of the campaign settings wizard. Now, let's walk through each one of them. The first step is General Settings. Here's where you name your campaign. There's also a field for an optional brief description of your campaign. Both the name and the description show up for your agents when they're assigned to a call. This helps your agents know what they're working on. Next, choose your business numbers for the calls, but keep in mind, international numbers aren't available for these campaigns. Last but not least, you can set specific start and end dates for your campaign. Choose the correct time zone and set the schedule for each day of the week. This will ensure you don't call your prospects at the wrong times and enables you to plan your outbound efforts in advance. Now, let's look at the second step, the dialer settings. Select the dialer type, in this case, Progressive, and continue with the related settings. Our first setting is ringing agent time. This is a period of time when the system is trying to reach an agent with the contact already on the line. You can determine how long that time period lasts. Then there's wrap-up time. For post-call work, when the agent selects one of the call outcomes or adds the number to the do not call list if needed. The max ring time is how much time is spent dialing a contact. The default retry period is how long before you tried calling the number again in case it wasn't reached during the first time. Finally, max attempts per number is the limit on how many times that you will dial each number associated with the contact. Now let's look at the system disposition. This is where you decide what happens to calls that don't connect. You can see some predefined call outcomes such as contact busy, contact no response, contact abandoned, invalid number, and answering machine. When the answering machine detection feature is enabled, the Progressive Dialer connects agents only to calls with the real person on the line, avoiding answering machines and voicemail, which further minimizes agent downtime. For each of them, you can choose whether this outcome is final, meaning no actions will be taken after that, or if you want to proceed with trying, choose the retry option and the number will be dialed again. You can also set up custom rules for each disposition retry. The next step of the setup is the agent disposition. Here, you can add and modify the call outcomes that your agents can select after completing a campaign call, dispositions which are then seen in the campaign reports section. You can enable some of the default ones or add your own tailored for your campaign-specific details and needs, up to 30 agent dispositions in total. The customizable retry option is also available here. Once you set up all of these parameters, your auto dialer is set. But of course, you still need to choose the agents who will actually be participating, and you have to upload a record list to start the campaign. This is what we're going to be talking about next. In the agent list section, you choose the agents who will be driving your campaign forward. All your current users show up here for selection, so simply check the boxes of those who you want to be included and continue to the final record list section. This step is all about the numbers you'll be calling as a record list. In essence, it's your contact list. If you already have the list of contacts you want to reach, great. You can just upload a CSV file. You can always use a provided template to format your record list for smooth, easy use in MightyCall's outbound campaigns. You can also upload CSV files that don't match our import template, and MightyCall will automatically map them for you, meaning your list will be ready to go. Now, keep in mind, the file size cannot exceed 100 megabytes. Doubly so, keep in mind that files larger than 15 megabytes may take 5 to 7 minutes to upload, so don't upload them at the last minute. If you've already created at least one record list, you'll see them in the section on the right. If you want to use one of those, just choose it here. Now you can manage existing lists by clicking on the three dots. Choose Add More to add new records to the existing ones, with checks for duplicates and proper phone number formatting. Replace to completely replace existing records in the list with the new ones, and of course, you can delete the list or export it to a CSV file. Once you complete all of these steps, your campaign's ready. That's it. Hit save, and now you can run it. Now, the federal government has something called the Do Not Call Registry, which is colloquially known as the Do Not Call List. It's a voluntary registry where people with American-based telephone numbers can very easily register their phone numbers. By doing so, they legally protect themselves from, and we're quoting the Federal Trade Commission here, unwanted sales calls, live calls, or robocalls from real companies that follow the law. If you activate the integrated national DNC list scrubber that MightyCall provides, it scrubs all phone numbers included in the registry from your campaign list, protecting you from those potential fines and legal jeopardy. MightyCall's national DNC list base is constantly updated, which guarantees the most up-to-date compliance. Now, MightyCall's account DNC, which is do not call, list is an optional setting used when you have multiple numbers you wish to block calls for. Think of it as an internal block list. To enable it, look for the section in the upper right corner and click upload. Remember to follow these requirements for the file. The maximum file size can only be 10 megabytes. The maximum number of records, 9,999. The maximum number of records within one record list, it's 100,000. The format, again, must be CSV. After the list is uploaded, you can add more records to it, of course. You can replace it with a new list, you can delete it, and of course, you can export it to a CSV file. Agents can also select to add a number to the DNC list on the account as they're going through the campaign. If they completed a call and somebody wanted to be added to the list, they can do so by selecting a call outcome. Creating do not call lists helps to avoid unwanted interactions, and it protects your business's credibility in doing so. Once your campaign has been created, you'll see it in the auto dialer main tab. Each campaign can have one of the following statuses. If it's ready, the campaign is set, it's ready to begin. If it says it's incomplete, that means at least one of the settings is missing and needs to be filled out. Remember, a campaign needs to have at least one number, one agent, and one client to run. If it says preparing, the record list is being imported. Just wait a couple minutes until it's done. If the status says running, that means the calls are happening at this very moment. If the status is set to paused, that means nothing's happening. The campaign has been put on hold. Obviously, if it says completed, all the calls within the campaign have been made. You're done. Finally, if it's scheduled, that means the campaign has not started yet, but it will start in the future based on the start date set in the settings. Simply click on the button to the left of the campaign's name to launch, pause, or resume your campaigns. If you want to edit campaigns, be aware of some restrictions. You can't edit completed campaigns. If your campaign is in the running or pause status, then you'll only be able to edit the general settings and the agent list. Finally, you can't delete running campaigns. Other than that, you can edit your campaigns by clicking on the three dots and choosing edit. That's it for the Progressive Dialer setup process. If you still have any questions, please let us know in the comments or contact our support using the contacts on the screen now. Have a great one.